So the minimum possible maximum depth is 1. So if we start with a node here that we're going to number 0, okay, and then we're going to have a graph where every single node is attached to that root node. Okay, well, the depth of each one of these is going to be 1. On the other hand, the maximum possible max depth is going to be n minus 1. So what's our graph look like there? We're going to start with the root node, and then we're going to have a linear chain of graph nodes all the way out to n minus 1. Now, it's important for you to realize these are two very different graphs from the point of view of parallelization. This linear chain here, very hard to parallelize. If we're doing a BFS, it's going to take us order of n steps to get from the start node all the way to the end node. Not going to get a lot of parallelization out of that. And clever students are going to realize this is the worst case step complexity of the BFS. But if we have a graph that looks like this, a star-shaped graph, then parallelization is a lot more straightforward. We can process each one of those leaves independently and in parallel.